In a previous video, we added interaction into our project, allowing our character to have more upgraded hand interactability. But today, we're going to be implementing locomotion, which means we'll be able to move our characters with the joysticks and see them switch between generative leg animations and predetermined walking animations. Let's start by creating a new empty game object and calling it character. And let us reset its transform to 000. Now let's add a component called animator hooks. And we need to take our avatar that we set up previously and put it as a child of this new character game object. Let's now head into our avatar and select the locomotion controller as our animator controller. This comes with the movement SDK. And please make sure to untick the apply root motion if it is ticked. Next, let us add another empty game object into our hierarchy and call it player controller. Let's reset the position to 000. Or wherever our character is, so it has to be the same position. And now we'll need to add a couple components. First, let's add a capsule collider. Let's put the height to 1.8 and the center Y axis to 1.8 divided by 2. And let us put the radius to 0.14. Let's make sure this is a trigger collider. Now let's add a sphere collider, which will act as our feet collider. Here, we'll need to put the radius to 0.125 and the center to also 0.125. Should look something like this when you're done. Now, we'll need to add a rigid body and make sure it has use gravity ticked on. And finally, we'll need to add a sphere collider stays below hips component. Now, into our collider field goes the sphere collider. Into the expected body capsule field goes the capsule collider, and into the character root goes the character game object that we just created. For the next part here, tracking hips and tracking toes, we'll need to look at our specific rig to check which joints correspond to these. So let's head into our character rig, go into avatar. Here we can click on our avatar and press configure. Now we can check that the hips are called hips, and that the toes are called left toe base. The same is called here for the right leg, right toe base. So these are the bones that we should be dragging into that specific field. So let's go back now, go back into player controller. And here in the tracking hips, let's open up our avatar. Let's go into armature, hips, that's the one. Drag it and drop it into the tracking hips. Now we'll need to add two more fields here. Open up our hips, open leg up and right up leg. Continue until you see left toe base and right toe base. Now this is specifically for this rig. If you want it for your other rigs, you need to also check which joint is the specific one needed here. And just like that, we have it set up. Don't take the collider follow toes. And there's one more component we need to add into our player controller. So let's search for movement SDK locomotion and add that. Here, we can drag the player controller into our rigid body. And for the collider, we need to specifically drag the sphere collider. So let's do that. And then here, everything can stay the same. In the camera rig, we need the reference to the camera rig. So let's open up our interaction rig OVR, get the camera rig and place it into this field. Here, we'll need to add an event on the on user input change. Let's drag our character in here and let's go into animator hooks and input horizontal vertical. Now on the start move and stop move, we need to add two more events, but we will get back to that later. Next up, let's right click on the player controller and create a new empty game object as a child. Here we'll call it controls and let's add an OVR input binding component. For the buttons, we'll add two buttons. These will be for turning left and right, so we can rotate our character. Let us name the first binding snap turn left and the second one snap turn right. And here we'll add two booleans, one on each. We will give it the player controller and we'll go into movement SDK locomotion, snap turn left, and for the right one, snap turn right. Like so. Now if we scroll down, we'll add one more binding to the joystick. we'll call it move, and we'll add a notifying vector. We'll give it the player controller, and we'll go into the movement SDK locomotion again, and we will call user input. Next, let's make sure to give them the correct buttons and axes to use. So let's scroll back up, go into button on the snap turn left, and use secondary thumbstick left. And for the controller, we'll use touch. For the right one, we'll use secondary thumbstick right and touch. And finally, on the joystick binding, we'll use the axis secondary thumbstick. After that, we'll add another component called Unity Input Binding. And same as we did, we'll add a new horizontal vector to be taken into consideration. And we'll get the player controller and call the function user input. In this next step, we'll need to use two different scripts to make sure that the camera rig and our character are moving along with our player controller. So let's right click on player controller. Let's create a new empty game object and let's call it OVR camera rig follows locomotion. Now let's add a transforms follow me script and let's add a new element and drag in the OVR camera rig. Now we can duplicate this game object, rename it to, instead of OVR camera rig, to character object follows locomotion. And we will replace this with the character. So let's go into character and drop it here. Just like so. So now we have the OVR rig follows locomotion with the OVR rig element and the character object follows locomotion with the character element. In this next part, we'll be adding a game object that will take care of masking and unmasking the legs so that when we are moving with the controller, we see the animations, and when we're moving just with our body, we see the genitive legs. So let's right click on the player controller, create a new empty game object, and let's call it locomotion animation constraints for legs. In it, let's add a new component called animation constraint masker, and let us unhide the assets that are not in the assets folder and choose upper body joints mask for the mask. And for the animator, let us just open up our character and drag in our avatar. If we head into our mask asset, we can see what it's supposed to look like. We open up humanoid, and you see the upper body is active, but the legs are masked. So what we're doing is we are activating this mask when we start moving with the controller so that only our upper body is controlled with our motion and our lower body is moving according to a preset animation. Now we can go back into our player controller, go to the fields that we didn't fill in, and we can drag in the locomotion animation constraints mask. And here we'll choose the function inside of animation constraint masker called start applying mask 4 in the start move function. And in the stop move function, we'll choose the finish applying mask 4. And let's not forget to fill this in with the word locomotion. If we are using the Interaction SDK hand integration as we are in this project, there's still one more step we need to do. Otherwise, we have already fully integrated locomotion into the project. Let's quickly add that one more thing and let's test it out. Let us right click on our player controller and create a new empty game object. Here we'll call it bones follow locomotion with static character. And we'll add into it a new component called skeleton translate processor. In the hands field, we'll need to add four hands, which stands for each of the synthetic hands. So let's put four right here. Press enter, and we'll need to open our interaction rig OVR, go into OVR interaction, open up OVR controller hands and OVR hands, and you'll see these OVR left hand synthetic, right hand synthetic, and the same here. We'll need to drag those into those fields. So first of all, the left hand, the right hand, then the left hand again, and the right hand again. And into the alternative character mover field, we'll need to drag in our character object follows locomotion from the player controller, just like so. Now finally, we need to head into our avatar, scroll down into the skeleton process aggregator, which we created in the previous video, and we'll need to add a new processor and drag into it the bones follow locomotion object, like so. And make sure to have this bones follow locomotion with static character object above the retargeted bone targets, just like so. And last thing we forgot to add is a collider on the floor so that our character doesn't fall through the ground because he now has a rigid body. So let us select the ground and just add a box collider. Simple box collider like so will do. Now we can test it. All right, as you can see, we're still moving with our avatar if we walk. But now, if we take our controllers, we can move with the joystick and you'll see our character moving with the legs. So we have animations on the legs. We can walk around. We can also rotate our character to look. And when we stop, we're back to moving with generative legs, as you can see. And we can still interact with all of our objects just like we used to. There we go. Awesome. And there you have it. We've been able to successfully implement locomotion into our project, making it so that our avatar can now move with both generative legs and joystick movement with animations. And with that, we mark the end of our Getting Started with Movement SDK playlist. If you enjoyed and learned something new, don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button. And as always, I will see you in the next one.